is that we spend, being is that we spend 5 days a week filming our lives, and we talk about some pretty intimate things, we wanted to take a day to talk about what we don't talk about and what you don't see on this vlog. I think this is an important thing to address because without realizing it might be easy to assume that you guys are getting a good, well-rounded picture of our life just because you see some of these like really intimate details. And I really don't think it's that way at all. I mean, I guess compared to a stranger, I think you guys would know us a lot better. And you can know a lot by what people talk about, but there's so much that like we just don't cover and we can't cover, some on purpose, some on accident.
All those moments in our life that don't have background music, there's a lot of those.
So the first thing, the baby crying. The baby whines and cries a lot around here. It's just like where he's at, and we're fine with it. We don't think it's broken. I actually don't mind sharing it, except for I think it makes for like really shitty vlog content. Like no one wants to listen to a baby crying. Like just hearing it, it puts you in a bad mood, and it almost makes it impossible to like observe, learn, or enjoy anything else. And not that our vlog episodes are all about you enjoying your life, but it's like, okay, the second thing is boring stuff. So much of our life is like, I don't know, cutting coupons and making phone calls and...
Like Ben and I were just sitting out here like staring at each other with fingers up our nose.
And before that, we walked to the dry cleaners and then we walked to the grocery store. Sometimes we're not in the mood to film. Sometimes it doesn't fit in with a story. Sometimes it just seems pointless. But these are all a part of our life. You know, those little decisions that we make, and sometimes it feels like actually the much bigger part of our life that we don't show. Next, interactions with the kids. This is one of those things like I just wish was different, but we have to choose between family intimacy or the vlog quality. And we have to choose family intimacy. So there's all sorts of interactions we have with our kids have with each other, that I wish I could just bring the camera like right in the middle into and film it and show it like live. But the problem is the camera changes the environment. Like it really does. Like the way that we talk is different.
It intrudes, really. Which sometimes we're okay with that intrusion and then sometimes it's not worth it.
Like something like this, we're sitting down here, and this is one of the things I think we do pretty well, is we set the camera up and then we talk to the camera. But there's this other form of vlogging that some people do, which is they just like take the camera into their life and they're like talking to their kids and they're holding the camera here. And we can't do that. And I have no idea how those other people do it too.
It's harder to find the boundaries when you do that style. Because the boundary right now is very clear. Like I just told Filia, we don't want to be interrupted. Okay, mom and dad are out here, we're talking to the camera. But when the other way is like, it just makes things kind of weird.
The best case scenario is you guys get to see something awesome, but I almost feel like it would be fake because the camera's there and people are changing the way we live for the camera. Yeah. Which crosses a line of vlogging for us. Not helpful stuff. There's a bunch of things in our life that are important to us and that we're learning and going through, but we just can't think of helpful ways to share it with you guys yet. There's some things that we think would be more confusing to share or just more weird, and we've tested it out in certain ways by sharing some of our beliefs, but it's hard to know which is which, and sometimes I feel like oh, to hell with it, just share everything. But I don't think that's very wise. Bullshit accusations. So this is more of a recent one in our life, locally around here. In the last couple years, we've shared with some of you guys some of the difficulties that we've gone through. And we've had different levels of people to our faces, but mostly behind our backs, accusing us of things. Sometimes I feel the need to like defend myself or explain to you guys, oh, these are the accusations being called upon us, at least what it sounds like, and this is our response, and this is kind of like what happened. It seems like that's gonna turn into like he said, she said. And also, like, gives more power to these things that ultimately we've decided, like, the best thing we can do is kind of just, like, pretend like they're not important, because in the grand scheme, they're really not that important to us.
It really sucks to get accused of things, especially behind your back. And that has taken a huge emotional toll on us, that I'm not afraid to say that to you. Like, there's some days that are actually really shitty because of those kinds of things. But as far as specificity about that, yeah, we don't really wanna, at least at this point, don't really wanna go.
Sometimes my fear though is like, oh, someone will find out about these accusations and they're gonna be like, oh my gosh, we feel so lied to, like, why didn't you tell us? I can understand how that feels, like if you feel like shocked or surprised. We're taking it seriously in a way, but we're trying to have these things lose their power, not gain more power. This is like one of the biggest ones, is Cammy being funny. Because I feel like there's so many moments in our real life where she makes these like jokes. I don't know, you guys have, some of you who have been around a while have seen her animal impressions. It's really a treat. Let's come up with one now. Dolphin.
Seriously?
Come on. You're just feeling pressure.
Yeah.
Okay, bunny rabbit. I think that's funny. But it doesn't come up very much on camera. I don't know why. I think because a lot of the camera time feels more serious and scripted, and I think partially that's my persona. But I wish it did, because I think you're so damn funny, and I wish we were able to capture more of that on, like, just in regular life. Like, she's not even trying. That's when I think she's the funniest.
I watch some vloggers that they just like pick up, especially like women vloggers, like they pick up the camera and they're just like, blah, 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 blah. I feel like I could do that. Maybe I should use the smaller camera for those, because sometimes it's just intimidating to like pick. I mean, this camera is big and huge and it's better quality, but for that kind of stuff might be like, yeah, we're still working on that.
Next topic we don't cover is spanking. We talk about it, but we don't really show it. And I'm kind of torn on this. Like, I actually really wish we showed it more, because I think it's actually just so important in our life. And right now, this is specifically with Rainier. He's 1.5 right now.
Almost 2.
And we do a ton of, like, flicking, spanking his hands, spanking his butt. Like, every once in a while, it gets kind of, like, heavy duty, like major, where I think he actually feels pain. But usually it's not like, you know, it doesn't leave a mark or anything. But it's like, it's such an important part of our relationship with him, and I think how he's growing and how our other kids, like how we were able to cope with them at this age.
It's boundary setting is what it is. And we're telling him, no, okay, you just didn't do what we said. Okay, we need to show you a boundary, and to us, showing him a boundary the best way is to spank him or flick him.
But I don't like showing it for two reasons. One is, like, I have this like CPS thing in the back of my mind where if like putting our family in jeopardy compromises our, like sharing the message actually compromises our regular life, it's just not worth it. And the second is, I don't know, I feel like they're actually like really intimate moments that it feels kind of weird to like shine a camera on, and I don't know how to overcome that gap besides talking about it after the fact. But sometimes I think some of the best teaching opportunities would come if someone was in our house and they just like watch this go down. In fact, we've heard that from people. Mm-hmm. And they're like, oh, I didn't know that could happen that way. And mm-hmm. you know, you could spank a kid, not be angry, mm-hmm. then you watch the kid actually learn, like right before your very eyes. That's just one taste of things we don't talk about on this vlog. I actually think there's so much more. There's a bunch of sexual stuff that I have like kind of like scheduled for certain vlog episodes where I'd like to get more explicit for those that would be helpful. But sometimes I feel kind of burned because it doesn't take many voices in our head to just be like, wait a second, are you guys like crazy? Like, how come we're the only people from this angle sharing that kind of stuff? Mm-hmm. So I'm like, oh, am I just like trying to get attention? And I know it's not that. It keeps me not very motivated. So in a way, I feel like we just share the tip of the iceberg. But I just wanted you guys to get a more well-rounded picture of maybe who we are, or at least how much you can get to know us from watching this vlog. At the end of the day, I just want to remind you guys that this vlog, it's it really is like a product. It's a piece of content that we prepare. It's highly, highly prepared. Everything from what is filmed to what is edited to what is published. I mean, it goes through three stages of editing, and there's so many different reasons that we're deciding whether to put a clip in or take a clip out. And it's really hard to know like what to feature and what not to feature. You know, what's helpful, what can we handle, what do we feel like is honest, what do we feel like is deceiving, or what do we feel like is gonna add value to the world? You know, there's some stuff that, there's just like plenty of other vlogs out there showing you how to clip coupons and make a dinner plan. That's not our thing. Now, so we might even like do those things, but we're not like trying to make that the point of the vlog. I would like to see in the comments, what do you guys want to see more of in the vlog? And please be specific, because I'm in a place right now where I'm like trying to think if we should be rethinking the vlog in terms of what we're including and not. Like maybe we're gonna be doing more talking segments, because it takes a ton of energy to film and edit together all these pieces, and I'm like, you know, was that really that helpful at the end of the day to see another workout? Comment, subscribe, like, buy our merch. We don't have any merch. Goodbye.